welcome to the Bomb Show, and today we're doing a comparison review, a little more casual, but we're going to be comparing an older piece and the new rendition of that piece.
So, without any further ado, here they are. This is the original.
And this is the new one.
This is the new ED-209 Hot Toys Robocop. Oh, they almost barely fit on screen. 1/6 scale figures, so it gives you an idea of both boxes.
Yeah,
I actually like the new box better. It looks nicer.
It's more stylized.
It looks more upscale, high end than this one. This one's basically the old one's. And funny thing, this is MMS12. What is that?
204.
Wow. So these are separated by 192 releases. That's crazy, right? This is MMS12. This is gangster. This is actually a Hot Toys model kit when you had to put them together. Funny thing is
that this also has to be put together exactly the same way.
Exactly the same way as the original ED-209.
Although it's not considered a model kit, but if you notice, the other one did have a handle at the top for carrying. In this case, this came in a shipper, and that shipper had a handle on it for carrying.
Plastic handle.
A little bit of a difference there. Yeah. And just the main image on the front, manufacturing info on the back, no other photography on the new box.
Nope, none at all.
Very, very different design to the box, but stylized. It has kind of a honeycomb textured coating on it. Pretty cool and stylized, definitely a little bit more classy looking than the original.
Right, and the boxes are pretty much almost identical in size.
One's
a bit longer and one's a bit taller. That's it. This one's about an inch and a half longer, this one's about an inch and a half taller, and their depth is exactly the same pretty much too. Another thing to mention is as far as putting these guys together, they're the type of things that particularly the legs on the new RoboCop and arms and legs on the original, I'm sorry, ED-209, they're like snap into place, and once you lock them in, they're kind of locked in, and it's pretty...
You don't want to put it together until you plan on leaving it.
Right, we wouldn't recommend putting it together if you think you're going to have to put it back in the box soon or have to whatever. Not something you want to take apart and put together again. But anyway, let's go. I'm going to go grab the ED-209s.
All right, so now you can see them side by side. Yeah, I mean, they do obviously look similar. You could definitely tell they were both ED-209s. You do notice a significant amount of additional detail on the new rendition of ED-209. There are a lot of nuances that are different. Just where rivet holes are and stickers and labels and things that are different between the two. But overall girth is a significant difference. If you just look at like these toes compared to these toes, they're very, very significantly bigger, I guess. Overall girth, you just looks a little thicker all around, and everywhere you look, you see details that are not on the older one. They have really nice paint jobs on all the metal pieces. Instead of just being silver paint, they really are painted to look a lot more like actually truly metal pieces, even though they aren't. A lot more of the wiring is actually wire and not like painted on or omitted.
And then there's actually little braided wires. They look like actual mini braided wires. The detail on this one is the first Hot Toys re-release that I actually have to say is really, there's worlds of a difference between the two. And the thing is, usually I would complain and I wouldn't be happy with re-releases because they would usually take away all kinds of features and remove all kinds of things, but I can totally justify why this piece is like $200 more than the original. This is basically double the price of the original one. When we got this one was basically $220, and this one's over $400, original retail.
Yeah, full price.
Our price is a little less, but original retail, this guy's $410, I think, right?
And, I mean, that is a lot of money, but for what you're getting, the amount of detail that they have put into this piece, it's impeccable.
This is literally, to give you an idea, the original ED-209 has 15 points of articulation. So basically you have 1 point at each ankle, you have 1 point at each knee, you have 2 points at each hip, you have 2 points on each arm, and the head swivels. That's 15 points. This guy has well over 60 points of articulation. He's loaded. He has just, there isn't anything I can remember from the film RoboCop. And let me tell you something, I watched RoboCop till the tape popped. I watched that movie so many damn times. There's nothing I can remember in the movie at all that actually seemed to be mechanical, functional, or whatever on this guy that I can't find on this figure. This thing,
Well, go ahead.
It has every single, and I mean, I studied the crap out of, I used to draw RoboCop and ED-209 every day in school in 10th grade. I failed the 10th grade because I drew RoboCop every day in school. And this guy has everything. I mean, I'm gonna get right into I'm gonna give you a small section right now of what actually is on the new version that just was totally just wasn't on this piece, on the original piece. So here we are. I'm gonna basically show. I'm gonna point out what's new on this model. Versus the old MMS12 model kit version. So the new ED-209 basically, okay, first off, as far as articulation or features or whatever goes, you get, if you remember before ED-209 fired his arm rockets, he had this aim piece that actually you have to put this on. Just kind of took it off by accident. And it actually rotates forward. And then the missile rack becomes armed, and these missiles actually can, the missiles actually can be removed. There's three missiles in there. That's the missile. So they actually can be removed from his rocket launchers. Or from his rocket launcher. He only has this on his right arm. And so then that would fold back down. And then his aiming thing or whatever that peripheral is would fold back. That's totally new. They had some detail of that on the old version, but that's definitely, it didn't function this way. All this wiring, all this detail, all this metallic stuff going on here, these braided wires, that's all new. Now, he did have the ratchet joint at the elbow there. But he did not swivel at the forearm. The new ED-209 swivels at the forearm. The old one didn't do that. He's also got the clips that shift when he was reloading his clips. He has one on the right arm and on the left arm, he's got two of these shifting clips, which are really cool. And this arm also rotates at the forearm, which they didn't do before. Now, if you notice underneath his wings here, I'll call them wings, he does have a ball joint on the shoulder, but what's also new to the new ED-209 is his actual shoulder mount swivels. If you see that, that whole entire mount there swivels, whereas the old version, it just had the ball joint here, which is a whole nother point of articulation. That articulation alone is adds up to the entire articulation of the old ED-209. That's 15 points there. This you have to count as articulation because this is a movable part. So that's a functional point of articulation. Next up, another big deal. The old ED-209 rotated at the waist here like this. This ED-209 has a double ball jointed neck section or core section, meaning his head can not only go forward, back, left, right, but it can totally swivel around from the body, which is really cool. And he's got nice rubber boots or rubber shoes where all of his articulation points, where all the main articulation points are. So that's really cool. So as you can see, he can lean forward and back. The old ED-209 could only swivel his head on a flat axis. That was it. Okay, next up we have double ball jointed hips, same as the original ED-209. However, from that point on, the only thing the original ED-209 had was swiveling leg point here, and the actual foot, the ankle, had a swiveling point, which this one also has. But everything else that I'm going to show you is completely new articulation or movable parts on this ED-209. First of all, we've got the back and forward rotation at the kneecap, which is totally new, and you got these cool pistons that actually work with the rotation, which is totally new. Sick, man, those actually look metal and everything. Next up, we have the actual ride height, which we showed you guys already, the actual telescoping legs. So his legs will actually ride up and down on these tracks, on these four beam tracks. You also have, I don't want to do that now because I don't want to get too shaky and I don't want to go out of frame with the camera. You also have the locks that lock the tracks in place, which are really cool. Well, they don't actually lock the tracks in place on the toy, but that's what it kind of seemed like their function was in the film. Every time he would either get into relaxed position or stand at attention or finish or start walking, these things would always shift and lock up and or unlock, and his, you know, legs would continue to move. So those are totally new also. Something that's really cool on this also is when this portion of the leg goes all the way down on the track, they actually give like suspension bumpers there on the front and backs of the legs. Doesn't actually interfere with these when you lower the legs all the way down, but that's just a really cool detail for them to add, because that was probably part of the original prop model that was used in the film, so they probably kind of got duplicated it from that, which is sick. That's fantastic. Next up, which is a really cool detail, which I totally remember from the film and I never thought they would do this, these actual, that coil there and these top pistons would actually rotate when ED-209 walked, and they actually do rotate on the toy, which is pretty unbelievable. I never thought they would do that. That is completely above and beyond what I expected for this re-release. Next up, is that all on the upper part of the legs? Okay, now we get down to the feet. Yeah, that's all we get. Now we get down to the feet. The feet are completely blown out. I mean, even the bottoms of the feet. Look at the bottoms of the feet on this guy. They're insane. But anyway, down at the feet, the old ED-209 had, he had a ball-jointed ankle. This guy's got a ball-jointed ankle. However, he's also got completely independent moving toes. All four toes move independently. They do swivel. They are not on ball joints though, but they swivel up and down. They pivot up and down. So you got those four extra articulation points on the feet. And, which is really cool, if you look up close at the front of the ankle area there, he's got a collapsing plates for further, for more of a movement. It gives more of a radius on the movement on the toe, so it can collapse into the foot, which is awesome. But not only that, they went and on the front of the toe, he's got a collapsing plate on the toe as well. So that's like, it's like a double collapsing point there for the feet to really, the toes to really fold up and get in. You get a really good fold on the foot, which is crazy. Not only that, but they did it on the side toes as well. The side toes also have the collapsing panels on them, which is beautiful. All this detail in here, all this wiring, all this metallic going on, all of these moving points. I mean, the original ED-209 had 1, 2, 4 points of articulation per leg. I mean, this has more than that just on the toes. So they really blew this thing out. I don't know. I think this is such a phenomenal piece. And re-release or not, this thing is amazing. Even if you have the first one, get it, man. This thing is so bananas.
So yeah, I think that's about all for the articulation.
And anyway, as you can see, all of those details that are on the new guy that just weren't on the original are just, it's amazing. I mean, all the stuff they did with this guy's mechanical functions and just the details, unbelievable. Let me get Robocop so you can see what they look like standing next to him.
And just the major, major difference when this guy is ramped up in his full height, he towers over.
I'll show him right here real quick. Let me just open the leg things a little. Watch this. This is what really makes this guy insane. In the film, when ED-209 would, when he was in rest position, this was his size. And I mean, this one's still a little bigger than the original. But when he would actually get up and start walking, he would grow to about that size. So he goes from basically 14 and a half inches in height in relaxed mode, he goes to 18 inches high. So this guy is the size of the Ironmonger when he stands up. However, is way more girth. This thing is, it's enormous, man. This thing just, I have to say, and everybody know, anybody who knows me and knows my ways, I'm a diehard old school Hot Toys model kit aficionado, and I have to say, man, yeah, the new ED-209 destroys the original. It really does. I have no problem with forking over the extra money we did to get a piece that we already owned. No problem. This one's so much cooler.
Final words. Awesome new piece. If you have the old one, as we did, don't think that satisfies
you. Yeah.
This is a way better piece.
If you're one of those people that thinks that the new Hot Toys Predators are way better than the old ones, there's a way larger margin of difference between these two guys than there are between any new Predator versus any old Predator. This guy is absolutely 100% the bomb. I did not think Hot Toys would go anywhere near the detail they put into this re-release.
And we used to think that this one was the bomb.
This one was fine for me up until about 3 hours ago. and I am wearing the same shirt as I wore in the other video. What are you gonna do? I've been working too hard. Yeah, man. If you are a RoboCop or an ED-209 fan, I was really, really, really excited about the diecast RoboCop. This one, I wasn't so. What?
I guess.
What?
What? Sounds, you did that already.
Oh, that's right. We forgot. That's right. This is the main thing. Wait, let me get the remote.
Yeah, the other huge feature is the.
The last main sound. Difference, yeah, is that this one actually has. I'll let you hit that on switch. So wait. Let me sit down so they can hear. When you turn it on. Oh, and then it comes with the little RoboCop remote.
Yeah, the B and the O.
And this guy does, I think he has 7 different phrases. That's so bad. That's when he goes from relaxed to like standing mode and back and forth. Oh yeah, you better listen to that. and then they do the countdown. Oh man.
Of Penal Code 113, Section 9. You now have 5 seconds to comply. 4, 3, 2, 1. I'm now authorized to use physical force.
That's just way too cool. That is so awesome. The only thing that bugs me about this. This I think is a big oversight by Hot Toys. If you lose this remote or something goes wrong with it, you have absolutely no way of accessing the sound effects.
features besides turning it on and off where ED-209 kind of boots up. But take care of that damn remote. Don't lose it. Don't let it break, because I know if something happens to mine, I'll be on eBay spending $200 for one of these little junk
trays. Yeah, those I'm sure will be going for good.
These are
going
to be going for good money one day. So we might try to scoop one up if we can on eBay, go get something off the aftermarket. But yeah, man, ED-209. Robocop was one of my top five that I was anticipating for this year.
And that's just making me wonder what they're doing with Robocop. If they do make it that significant of a difference on Robocop, oh my goodness.
Yeah, I mean, just look at the ED-209. I mean, whatever. The piece is the bomb. We love it. We're almost sold out of it. We have, what, two left?
Mm-hmm.
We ordered a bunch, too. We only have two left. But this thing is magnificent. I actually think it is absolutely on par with the Ironmonger. And honestly, for me, I think it's cooler than the Ironmonger. I like it a lot more. And it's cheaper than the Ironmonger was. But I know all the Iron Man fans are gonna disagree with me. But whatever. It's all good. Oh my God, forgive Robocop. That looks like a fight to me. Woo-hoo! Man, that's a standoff right there. What's up? That it?
I guess so.
Yeah, I guess so. If you had any doubts about getting this guy because you had the old one, do yourself a favor.
Or if you are getting Robocop and you're like, I don't really need sure. ED-209.
Don't make the mistake of passing on this one, man.
This I can see in the aftermarket is
exploding.
Yeah. Beat.
It might not, but I could easily see. Like I said, it's definitely way more teched out than the Ironmonger. There's a lot of more moving parts and little intricacies going on all over the place. And it's bigger. I would have to assume it's probably around as heavy
too. He wasn't so buried in there.
Yeah, this thing is a beast. It is monstrous.
Oh yeah, I forgot to mention, ED-209 does also come with an alternate left arm, a switch out battle damaged arm, which I don't think I'll ever display him with, but if you're into battle damage, hey, it's pretty cool. It's a nice alternate display option. Oh yeah, and check it out. The Ironmonger weighs 4 pounds, the Hulk weighs 5 pounds, and ED-209 weighs 5.5 pounds. Bam!
I don't know how well you can see it between the two ED-209s here, but yeah, man, we love this piece. We highly recommend it. If you're an ED-209 fan, if you're a robot fan, if you're a 1/6 scale fan, high-end collectibles fan, get this, man. It's really, really...
Other thing we didn't really touch on is the visor.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
On the older one, the rubber over time on for most people started to crack a little bit. We thought maybe they wouldn't do rubber again. They did. It does seem like a more durable rubber, but time, who knows?
Yeah, I'm very surprised that Hot Toys went with rubber again for the dome. Like Wendy said, though, it does look like they may have more of a vinyl rubber kind of mix going on, so... Hopefully it looks like it. Hopefully it'll last longer.
Stands the test of time a
little
better.
Yeah, it definitely has a much deeper black and a shinier finish to it. So hopefully there's more vinyl in the mix and it just lasts longer. Because, I mean, we don't even play with this one. We don't touch this thing at all. And there is definitely, we got some little deterioration signs around it here. And it's not bad at all, but it's definitely, you know, but we've had this guy for... When did he come out?
I remember going out to New Jersey and
yeah, when did
this
we
guy.
Get this guy? We got this guy in
2006.
Yeah, so this guy is getting up there. This guy's 8 years old already. He's going on 9. So you could easily see 9 years of evolution in Hot Toys between these two pieces. More so than any other remake we know by Hot Toys. So get this piece if you can, man. This piece is no joke. That's it?
I guess so. Thanks for tuning in. I guess keep out a watch for any of our new content we have out and subscribe to The Bomb Show, please.
All right, you guys. Peace.